This PC was a technological marvel back in 2005. Fast forward to 2025, and we've brought both this retro rig and a modern powerhouse to TwitchCon to celebrate 20 years of gaming and tech evolution. Thanks to Nvidia and PNY for sponsoring this video, we're diving into how far we've come from Doom 3 to Doom the Dark Ages, and how today's tech lets us do more with less.
That feels sweet, actually.
This feels like a computer that I would have had.
Oh, what happened?
You got stabbed. Shoot the gun, shoot the gun.
Oh! Yeah, look at the reflections, that's sick.
So clear, so clear.
Feels like cheating, right?
Okay. What is your name?
My name is Jazzy Wazzy TV.
My name is Ebonique.
Mike Robb.
I'm That Boy Tipsy.
I'm Ion.
I'm Castle TTV.
Daniel.
Pastor Susie.
AJ Valdez.
Or you go by Mechanism.
I am Robot.
Okay, so what we're gonna do here is we're gonna journey back to 2005. Do you know what console launched in 2005?
The Xbox 360.
The Xbox 360, right? Reddit actually launched in 2005 as well.
Wow.
Do you know what big video platform launched in 2005?
No, honestly.
YouTube.
Really?
YouTube launched in 2005. So let's talk about the specs for our 2005 rig first. And we have to give a huge shout out to RemarkableRetro.com for building this incredible time machine for us. This thing features an Nvidia GeForce 7800 GTX with 256 megabytes of VRAM. Megabytes, which, by the way, this GPU was a legend back in 2005. This has got a Pentium 4 3.2 gigahertz CPU, 2 gigabytes of RAM, 120 gigabyte hard drive, which is like just a whole COD update in and of itself, and a DVD-RW drive. And we're also using a beast of a 1280 by 1024 CRT monitor. And the cost? About $3,000 back then, which would be around $5,000 today if we accounted for inflation. And that's not including the cost of the CRT. Now it's running Doom 3, and yes, we got the CD-ROM for full nostalgia.
All right, Jacob here from Nvidia, and what we are looking at is Doom 3, which released in 2004. What this game did that was pretty revolutionary at the time was simulate how lighting worked in the real world, or attempt at it. You can see the shadow here.
But all that tech made Doom 3 a demanding title to run, and even this high-end rig struggled to maintain smooth performance at $3,000. So we're gonna actually have you play Doom 3 on this system, just kind of experience it, all that sort of stuff. And then once you're done, we're gonna talk a little bit about that. And then we're gonna move you on to a more modern 2025 system. And then we're gonna talk about the difference in the experience, okay? So F is flashlight to switch between flashlight and gun. And then everything else is the standard controls. Okay, so let's go ahead and start playing. Tell me what you think as you start playing.
Yeah, it feels sweet, actually. It feels smooth, yeah, it feels smooth.
I can't see.
Shoot the gun, shoot the gun. Oh! Dude, you literally just got the authentic Doomix. Even the, you rage quit just like it was 2005. I mean, you're getting 60, 50. It's trying to stay at 60. Game, though, stands up, right?
It does, yeah. It's dropping the 40.
Oh, what happened?
You got stabbed from above. Okay, turn around, you watch the bridge kind of be, oh, no, no, what are you doing? Look at the lighting, man. It's still, I mean, what they were trying so hard to do back then, this was crazy for 2005.
It was, and I'm like really like kind of surprised that like it looks so good.
All right, well, first of all, it looks super smooth. The shadows are crazy.
Look at the lighting and stuff.
Oh, yeah,
like this is their version of like,
shadows.
Exactly. I mean, what do you think? I mean, it looks pretty dang good, doesn't it?
It's like a, this is what a mobile would look like nowadays.
Okay.
Like, I would say my iPhone can do this quality. It's kind of where it's at.
This feels like a computer that I would have had at least 10 years ago, 2015.
And you were happy, right?
Yeah,
you were so happy.
I was ecstatic.
Okay, Rhea, so what I've got in front of you is a PC from 2005. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna have you play Doom 3. Are you ready to experience it?
I don't have any hands.
Oh. Yeah, this is awkward.
Yeah.
Now, when we go 20 years later, we have Doom the Dark Ages, which uses path tracing, calculating the actual light rays from the light source to give you realistic reflections and also shadow. So you can see how much progress has been made in 20 years. Not only is this much higher fidelity, it's also double the resolution and three times the frame rate on a 5070 Ti, so it's pretty amazing.
Okay, so let's go and pause this.
Okay.
And now we're gonna move over to Doom the Dark Age. For max graphic settings,
okay.
You're on a 360 hertz MSI OLED monitor, right? So we're giving you the high-end experience here, high-end experience here, okay? What do you think just off the bat in terms of how it looks?
Fantastic. You can see the reflections.
Yeah, that's real-time ray tracing and patch tracing right there. Yeah, yep. I mean, this is 1440p.
Ooh, nice.
Everything maxed. You're at 172 frames per second already. So how does it feel though?
This feels a lot smoother, a lot quicker. This is a lot quicker.
Yeah, I know. And then if you look down, like, let's go back around, turn around. I mean, look at it, the real-time reflections. You got path tracing, all that sort of stuff, right?
Yeah, look at the, oh yeah, look at the reflections. That's sick. Yeah. Man, it's crazy.
See, look at the ray tracing, path tracing. I mean, look at the lighting, right?
Look how smooth, so clear.
You know, one of the things that I always thought about with old computers, old tech and stuff, part of the fun is in tweaking it. Nowadays, it feels like cheating, right?
It feels very smooth.
I mean, you're getting 194 frames per second right now. Okay, yeah, okay, I see you, gamer, okay. And then look over here to the right, man. Just look at that draw distance, yeah. The fog, like. Enter 2025. Doom the Dark Ages just dropped with even more groundbreaking technology. And here at TwitchCon, we're running it on a rig powered by modern day standards like DDR5 RAM and NVMe storage, both provided by PNY for this rig, as well as the PNY overclocked GeForce RTX 5070 Ti. This setup leverages Nvidia technologies like DLSS4 and path tracing for stunning visuals and high frame rates. As mind-blowing as it is to see the difference between these two systems, it shouldn't be a surprise that the modern experience is better, right? 20 years of progress will do that, but it's amazing to see how far we've come. Today, displays like MSI's MPG271QRX Gaming QD OLED that we're using offers higher resolution, faster refresh rates, and richer colors. And thanks to its introduction in 2013, adaptive sync technology like Nvidia's G-Sync has solved the screen tearing issues of the past by syncing game FPS with display refresh rates. And from a gaming standpoint, looking back, Doom 3 attempted a legendary feat, simulating real-time lighting with hardware like the GeForce 7800 GTX. Today, Doom the Dark Ages is leveraging RTX 50 series GPUs to deliver real-time ray tracing, global illumination, reflections, and now path tracing, which simulates light bouncing off surfaces, penetrating objects, and reflecting far more naturally than lighting of the past. Put that together with DLSS4 Ray Reconstruction's enhanced AI-driven denoising, and we're gaming today with even more realistic visuals than ever. But how does that transform the actual gaming experience? In 2005, Doom 3 ran at 40 to 60 FPS at 1280 by 1024 with no anti-aliasing. Today, Doom the Dark Ages runs on the RTX 5070 Ti at double the resolution with cutting-edge visuals, and we're pushing 200 FPS thanks to Nvidia's DLSS4 and multi-frame generation. And where anti-aliasing of yesteryears used to tank performance, DLSS handles it with the help of AI, improving image quality and reducing motion blur. So 2005, Pentium 4, 7800X GTX, yeah. Right? How much do you think a system like that cost back in 2005?
I'm probably gonna lowball it. Maybe like 900?
$750.
$600?
$1,500.
$10,000 to $12,000? $4,500 to $5,000.
Well, this system, 2005, $3,000 without the monitor. If you added the monitor and everything else, it was about $4,000. Inflation-wise, it's $7,000 in US today. Okay, so now here we are, 1440p, everything maxed out, 200 plus FPS. How much do you think this system costs?
About 5,000.
This is probably 5,000 to 6,000.
Well, 5K, probably.
I'd say like 27.
2,200?
At least 2K.
Like 2 grand?
It's $1,500.
No way.
It's $1,500.
No way.
$1,500,
that's good.
$1,500, $1,500. 7600X, 5070 Ti, 32 gigs of RAM, and a 1 terabyte Gen 4.
I paid more for that for mine. The specs aren't as good as this.
If you added this amazing MSI monitor, which this is an OLED, 360 hertz refresh rate, all that sort of stuff, you're looking at $2,500 all up. Right, with components from Corsair and everything, right?
You know, my wife's not gonna like me anymore because I'm gonna come home and I'm gonna say, I played on a 5070 Ti at the PNY booth. I need to go buy one. She's not gonna like me anymore.
When we think about where you've come from 2005 to 2025,
yeah.
Both in cost and then just ease of use of DIY, what do you think, man? Did you realize it was that much?
I didn't realize that we've changed that much, but going from like a Pentium 4 to a Ryzen nowadays, the technology has changed so much.
And then all in all, like, I mean, is it impressive what you can do with $1,500?
Oh yeah, 100%.
Well, thank you very much, man. I appreciate it. I hope you enjoy the rest of your TwitchCon. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you for being our guinea pig. And then all in all, I hope you had fun.
Yeah, it was a blast.
Have fun at TwitchCon.
Hey, thank you.
This journey through time showed us a very small picture of how gaming and tech have evolved over the years. And gaming, it's just one part of the story. TwitchCon, which we're at right now, this is a celebration of a platform that didn't even exist 20 years ago. And it's part of it too. Now we connect, build communities, and launch careers all powered by the same tech that has been pushing gaming forward. And with features like Nvidia Broadcast, which has virtual backgrounds and echo cancellation, the PCs we're using today are driving stunning gaming and high quality video streams at the exact same time. I don't think it's a stretch to say that I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing right now without all of this new technology, which gets me even more excited for what's coming in the next 20 years. If you want to build a modern rig like the one we use today, you can do it for around $1,500, including the GeForce RTX 5070 Ti from PNY. If you want to learn more, head over to GeForce.com to learn more about the RTX 50 series from Nvidia and check out PNY's lineup of components. Links for all of the parts and everything are down in the description. As always, we want to know what you think. What quality of life improvements have you seen in gaming over the past 20 years? What do you hope comes next? Let us know all that down in the comments below. Anyway, guys, that is it for us. We're gonna wrap here at TwitchCon, but make sure that you follow us on all the other social medias at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. And if you wanna continue the conversation, maybe chat about something you learned about on this video, head over to discord.gg/Robeytech. If you made it this far in the video, this place is rad, but we gotta go. Thank you for hanging out with me this long, and we'll see you on the next one.